So we have a preview of the second episode of the Bleach anime, and if you guys have already known from leaks that we heard from the Japanese pre-screening, some of this won't be new for you. However, we do have some official synopsis from the official Bleach website, and I'm going to read them out to you now and kind of give you my overall thoughts on kind of what to expect in this episode. So, it's as stated. Ichigo and his friends hear through Ryunosuke's messenger that the mysterious intruder that has attacked the Soul Society and the extent of the damage. Ichigo and his friends disband, but while Ichigo was looking around the town, Nell and Peshe, two former members of the Arrancar, arrive from Wakamundo. Wakamundo is also under attack by an unknown enemy, and the two ask Ichigo for help. As Ichigo and his friends head for Wakamundo, Kisuke Urahara appears before them. Now, of course, if you've been up to date with the channel, you would know that I already talked about this episode before when it came to be leaked by either audio or by the Japanese reception from it, and we can kind of talk about what to expect within this episode. Of course, what it tells you from this synopsis is probably the start of the episode, following up to probably some really cool fight scenes towards the end. Now, the reason why I say this is because the staff listing seems to have some really good action animators involved, so I imagine that this is really going to delve into the Apache, Mila Rose, and Sunsun fight against Kurge, is kind of my guess, and maybe some really cool action scenes as well with the Arrancar going against him or Kurge in general when it came to natural selection. That's just my guess. I don't know. I haven't seen the episode, unlike some in Japan, but that's my kind of synopsis from that. We also know from the leaks as well, again, if you're watching this, you're kind of expecting the leaks in general, is that we know that Peshe did ask, you know, Ichigo for help, and obviously we get a little bit of backstory, which is in canon filler, which is good. We love ourselves some in canon filler of Haribel against Yuha, or maybe more so against the Vandana Reich. So it is interesting to see how much of that we're going to get, and you know, even if it's a minute, I'll take it, because again, if you can really dive home some impact in regards to maybe Haribel's, you know, emotion or stress towards the whole situation of like the state that she's in, and maybe some emotion with Peshe, who's usually a comedic character, that's going to really drive force again some of those hitting points for Wakamundo and the state that it's currently in and the severity of the Thousand Year Blood War, because we've already got a taste of the World of the Living with Ichigo versus Iburn. We got a little taste with, you know, Yamamoto versus the seven people or nine people that came to declare war, as well as, you know, Sasekibe, you know, rest in peace. And now we're going to get to see Wakamundo, which seems to be, you know, a little bit more of in a worse situation out of the three worlds that currently exist. So I really hope that we get a little bit, you know, not too much, because, you know, I'm probably being a little bit unrealistic, but I hope we get quite a bit in regards to Haribel and about what's going on with the Arrancars there. I hope that, you know, we spend a good amount of time towards the end of the episode too, maybe with Kurge versus some of the Arrancars, or maybe some of the slavery that's happening that we've seen in some of the PVs, you know, of all the, you know, Arrancars shackled up. Now, again, I'm not quite sure how the episode is going to end, but I imagine it's probably from that PV where Ichigo's kind of got this like green tint on his face and he's looking down on what I would imagine is Kurge. That's just my kind of guess in all of this. But nonetheless, it looks like it's going to be a very good art episode and a very good animation episode, considering some of the staff that are working on it. My only issue here is, and that's only because I don't have much knowledge on the guy, is Mitsutoshi Sato. Now, again, I'm not familiar with him, but he is the episode director for this episode, and I only know him from a few projects, and the projects that I've known as, such as like Naruto, for example, or even Food Wars, these aren't episodes that he's worked on that are stunning by any stretch of the imagination. But again, that is my ignorance, and that is my only concern with maybe the direction of this episode. But considering we've got some great animation supervisors on this episode as well, kind of gives me a lot of hopes up as well for it. So I think it's going to be a really good standard episode with some really good fight choreography in an animation in general. So I don't really think there's anything for cause for concern, just something that I just wanted to throw in there, because hey, I can't wait for the review where I say, hey, I'm glad of where my expectations were and I'm glad of where, you know, they are now. Other than that, I know many people are going to be excited to see Kisuke again. So, yeah, I mean, everybody loves Kisuke, so. And everyone's going to love Nell as well. So I already know from the reactions that people are going to post, they're going to be, like, absolutely fanboying over Kisuke and fangirling over Neliel as well. Yeah, and I'm just generally interested for the setting of this episode as well, because, you know, episode 1 had an impact, so can episode 2 continue that? Because we know as well that episode 3 is most likely going to be Ichigo versus Kurge, if we're going from logic and pacing here, and that should be an interesting fight in and of itself, of just like, a lot of heat. Oh, and I guess I should mention as well briefly about the controversy in regards to Sasa Kibe's funeral, which had been going around the internet about certain, you know, things being taken out. Again, I will have to see the context behind that. We don't know if it's a good takeout from Byakuya or not. Again, I hope Sasa Kibe gets some kind of justice even now or in the future, because there is a teeny weeny bit of like of a past that we get to see maybe. But as it stands, you know, I'm hoping that, you know, it's a good scene, the funeral scene in general. So, you know, there's quite a few good parts in this episode that are going to be kind of adaptated. But of course, with that being said, if you like these type of videos where I talk about the previews and what my expectations are, of course, drop me a comment and drop me a like. It's always appreciated. And of course, hit that subscribe button as well. That being said, you guys, of course, have this fine day, Ben Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.